the business department have informed us students that we are going to continue with our schools, with our classes. It will not be cancelled, however. Hi guys, my name is Kiko from Kiko Speaks, and if this is your first time watching my video, please consider subscribing to Kiko Speaks YouTube channel so that you'll get notified on our upcoming videos. So, ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon ay patungkol sa May or summer term 2020 sa Centennial College. So, basically, I will be speaking only on behalf of Centennial College. I mean, experience of a student from Centennial College at hindi ito generalized sa buong universities or colleges in Canada. So I'm just speaking based on the experience and based on information that I'm having from the school. Ngayon, we got a message yesterday from the business department telling students na merong pagbabago in the next coming term, which is the summer term, and hopefully it will not affect the upcoming fall term, which will be in September. So basically, going back to the summer term and going back to the announcement that was made, the business department have informed us students that we are going to continue with our schools, with our classes. It will not be canceled. However, what we are doing now, which is online learning or distance learning, will be prolonged. So, ibig sabihin, mag-online study pa rin kami in the next coming summer term. So, ibig sabihin, walang pupunta sa school, even teachers will not be allowed to go to school unless maybe they are required by the dean or by the department or by the company as Centennial College, you know what I mean? There will be a lot of cancellations that will be happening. For example, cancel that na mga activities sa school, cancel that mga activities so far dito sa Toronto. So, lahat damay-damay na. But in terms of the school, ang mangyayari nga is we will do the distance learning education. Although the school is a little bit equipped with the technology, pero in our experience during this winter term when we started the distance education, we have been having problems when it comes to connectivity, when it comes to the internet connection, to the speed of the Wi-Fi and everything like that. Kasi lahat nagsasabay-sabay na gumamit ng internet. And hindi siya convenient. Hindi rin siya nakaka-inspire. Kasi may mga professors, may mga instructors currently na binabasa na lang nila yung PowerPoint presentation, which is actually not a good thing, because if you really want your students to learn, you should make a way for them to learn well. Hindi yung 3 hours yung klase mo, iti-trim down mo into 15 minutes just to get over with it. Ano parang, okay, fine, you have saved time and we have saved time as well, pero we are paying much, much more than the regular or the local students. So, you know, we deserve something better, something more exceptional experience, kumbaga, para sa mga international students, since we are paying for this type of courses. Hindi ko naman sila nilalahat. I mean, not every professor that I am having now are the same. So, may mga professors din ako na well commendable. For example, yung teacher ko sa finance. Although hindi siya relevant, sabi na natin, hindi siya major subjects sa aking program, which is marketing. Pero he is the one who's actually reaching out to students in order for them to learn. Kumbaga, namimigay pa siya ng grado, namimigay siya ng tips, ng points, kung paan namin ipapasa yung subject niya. Kasi kahit nga hindi naman relevant yung pinag-aaralan namin sa kanya, pero part siya ng curriculum namin. So, might as well pass the subject. Pero meron talagang ibang mga teachers na talagang gusto lang nilang pasadahan na yung lesson, pasadahan nila yung presentation, and that's it. That's called it a freaking day. Alam mo yun, parang nakaka-disappoint lang. Pero what can we do? This is the current setup that we're having now, and I hope that in the next coming term, which is the May term, okay, hindi siya May term, kundi summer term, eh, magkaroon naman sana ng konting pagbabago, alam mo yung change sa mga teachers at sa facilities ng school online. Kasi hindi naman na namin magagamit yung mga facilities sa school physically, pero at least sana kung paano na i-deliver yung module at kung paano mag-deliver ng klase yung teacher is something na pwede nilang i-improve. Kasi unlike ngayon, talagang hindi maganda yung experience namin when it comes to online learning or distance education. Kasi for example, meron kaming klase like right now at 4 o'clock. At divided yung klase kasi hindi siya na-accommodate ng technology ng school. Ibig sabihin yung web app na ginagamit ng school to accommodate online studies sa mga estudyante. I mean yung video streaming. Kaya nangyayari, hinahati yung mga students. So, first batch, you will be from 4:30 to 5:30, and the second batch is from 5:30 to 6:30 on a 2-hour class. So, basically, hindi nagme-meet yung iba't ibang students, at same group lang din talaga yung nagme-meet sa isang schedule. So, hindi siya nakakatuwa. Hindi rin siya nakaka-engganyo. So, parang nakakatamad pumasok by summer term. Pero since required kami sa aming program at wala kaming bakasyon, sa post-grad, kasi usually ang post-grad, dire-diretso yan. From first semester to second semester, hindi ka pwedeng mag-break in between. So yun, yun lang yung medyo nakaka-disappoint, yun medyo nakakatambad na mag-enroll, na parang mas gusto mo nalang mag-enroll by the next coming term, which is the fall term. Pero we're hoping that things will change, things will improve, until, alam mo na, graduate kami by the next term. Pero I'm not hoping to graduate by the next term. I mean, in the fall term, I will be graduating during that time. Kasi I will be having my own co-op or the on-the-job training. So, although hindi na ako papasok sa school per se, pero papasok pa rin ako sa curriculum ng school. So, ibig sabihin, under pa rin ako sa Centennial College. But I'm hoping na during this summer term is magkaroon ng pagbabago, magkaroon ng change, ng improvement, and everything na pwedeng makakontribute sa experience ng isang student like me and like you as an international student. So, yun lang, and thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to click on the notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga susunod pa mga videos. Good luck, and thank you so much for watching. This is once again Kiko from Kiko Speaks. Bye-bye!